The Pomona Nature Art Collective is the beautiful baby of the Daw Center for the Arts, the San Gabriel Mountains Forever, and the Pomona community. The aim was to provide Pomona youth with a space where they could create, explore, learn, and connect not only with their own creative side, but also with other students, with local artists, and with the outdoors. We've incorporated the arts by having workshops on painting, photography, mixed media, and theater. We've also talked about being responsible, conscious citizens of the world by discussing overconsumption, deforestation, recycling, pollution. We would use recycled materials for our projects, and we mostly had a vegetarian diet throughout our meals.
I would like to see in my community trees, no littering, or trash all around the world, and I want to see beautiful trees, parks, a nice place for children to play, no beer, no bad stuff.
What I want to see in my community is a safer place for people to live in, and a cleaner place.
Mm-hmm. Is your, where you live right now, do you feel it's not safe?
No.
No? How, tell us like what makes you feel not safe, what happens there?
Well, when I first moved there, it was like, they shoot like two guys, something like that. Uh-huh. And then sometimes I hear a lot of shooting there.
Okay.
And they said like there's a lot of, it's ghetto there.
It's ghetto?
Yeah.
Yeah, what do you mean ghetto?
Like it's dangerous.
It's dangerous?
Yeah.
Actually, I think I'd prefer a lot more electric cars. Like, a lot less air pollution. Right? Because it's ridiculous. You can't breathe. I hate it. And that dump that they're putting down, the transfer station, the waste transfer station, I don't want that here. I really don't. The community altogether is actually really good, right? But I'd like less graffiti and less gang violence.
But we connected these issues to people and issues of justice. So we would ask ourselves, who is mostly being affected by all this pollution? Who bears the burden of all this trash, all this waste we're creating? What do we want to see in our communities, and what do we not want to see? And how do we communicate our message through the arts?
We did two projects. You know, we did Flower Power and photography, Love Letter. And seeing, it was really cool because we separated into groups, you know, and we walked around Pomona. And kids were taking photos of somewhere they felt safe, somewhere that reminded them of like a safe spot within nature. And these kids were like, oh, I remember this plant, my grandma used to have it, and you know, oh, she passed away and it reminds me of her, you know, and all these like little facts about themselves, like you're knowing about it as they're telling you, you know. And sometimes looking at the photographs, you don't know the story, but just seeing the photographs, you can feel something, especially like some of the kids. They were trying to go and get different angles and like getting depth of field and this really like soft, pretty look. And it's like some of the kids are really quiet and they act tough and they're taking these beautiful photographs of flowers, and it's like they have a sensitive side. They need to let it out.
How was your day today? What did you do?
Well, we went walking to, we found out the wherever oaks are, there is poison oak and something to cure poison oak. I forgot the name. It is my first time here.
And how was it?
It was awesome.
Did you enjoy it?
Yes.
What kind of things did you get to do here that you don't get to do at home?
Well, we came to a waterfall, and then we got to walk for a long distance, and we learned new things. At home, I just watch TV.
Yeah.
And did like my homework.
Is there other fun places to play at home?
No, we live in an apartment, that's why.
So what is it like?
It's quiet. It's a safe place, but it's boring.
But
As far as youth, it's just getting out to the world, to nature, right? And they're experiencing a totally different world. And it's that like enthusiasm, that excitement that I see a lot in kids where they haven't seen snow, for example, right? So the first time that a kid sees snow, that's just something that just grabs them, right? It gets them really excited. And just seeing, you know, the kids play in the water, that for me, it keeps me wanting to do what I'm doing. Just because not too many kids from urban areas get to experience just being barefooted in the water.
The youth who partook in this program were very receptive and very engaged. They were incredibly creative and intelligent. Not only are we taking away a lesson on environmental consciousness and social justice, but the big takeaway is that our youth is ready, willing, and capable of getting involved, of learning, of creating, and so are the members of this community. So our role as audience members, as community members, is to support these efforts and to nurture this amazing potential in our youth.
Save the music, y'all. Save the music, y'all. Save the music, y'all. Save the music, y'all. Save the music.